Never get on to a stage without a podium. It's like being at sea without a life belt. You need something to hang on to. TEDxMunnar. I never thought I'd live to see the day when you had a TED conference at Munnar. We thought of two words distant in the universe. One would be TED and one would be Munnar. But what a great idea. Munnar is one of the most beautiful places on this planet. It refreshes the mind and the body and the soul. And TED does that for the mind also. If you look at the town of Munnar, you can see all the problems of the country and the world in microcosm. I was collector here many, many years ago, and the only thing here was a video shop. I used to drive all the way from Pineapple to come and take videos in the shop here. Look at it now. It's JK2 in Delhi in miniature. If this is the way the world is going to change in one generation, I'm really scared about what's going to happen. Seamless experience. The whole of Kochi city will now spread into the water. All those poor communities living on the Kochi lake will be able to access the town in 10 or 15 minutes. These lovely double-hulled catamaran boats will be floating in our water with modern jetties. So basically, Kochi is going into a global city once this 10,000 crore of investment happens in about another 2 years' time. We are also coming out with a Kochi One card, which will be a kind of unlock all the transportation possibilities too. It's already on the market. You can use it worldwide. You can also use it in Harrods in London as a debit card. This will also have other capabilities, like you can book your movie tickets, pay your power bill and water bill and so on. Please get a Kochi One card, because it also gives you 8 free lounge access in the airports of India. So you buy a card for 250 bucks, you can use it at various airport lounges. So basically, to cut a long story short, when we started this journey about 5 years back, we thought we should build a good metro and run it. But that's not enough. We quickly changed our corporate vision to the following. You connect people, that's our job. You connect people and places, that's our job. And when you do these two, what are you doing? You're connecting people with opportunity. You're giving them a better life. So we're basically a better livelihood company. I'll start with one more word about my company. My 34 years, I've worked in various sectors in the center and the state. I've never seen a company like MRL, because the average age of my people is 32. Those boys and girls will die for the metro. Their integrity and their passion and their honesty and their zest is what will keep this country going. When I see these young faces before me, I know the country is safe in their hands. I'm so proud of the fact that I had in building the metro. Any other IAS while I would have done it. But when I die, one thing I'll carry to my grave is the fact that I could build this personal organization, personally build this organization, brick by brick. I think Raji wanted me to say something about the season next year. Do I have a minute? I'll tell you.
Actually,
you have 4 minutes. Okay, oh, great. So she wanted some solutions for the Kurani season. I'll just give you some examples from Nilgiris. 3 things they did in the Nilgiris district. 1, building controls in terms of slope. In the Nilgiris, you can't build on a slope more than 30 degrees or so. Secondly, building controls in terms of size. Any building more than 2,500 square feet has to be approved by the collector. Before the collector approves the house, it has to go through such a rigmarole that nobody gets a permit. It will take 5 years to get permission for that. Thirdly, if you drive up to the Nilgiris, they'll stop you at the gate and check your car for plastics. Now, I was also Secretary of Urban Development here. We tried to ban plastics many years ago. Why are we not banning plastics? Because the whole industry is dependent on it. So as I was telling our Chief Minister the other day, you can't ban plastics so easily. Do it in a district like Idiki, where the manufacturing doesn't get affected, where there are security gates at every entry, and this whole district will bloom. So that's one thing you need to do. You have to lobby in Trivandrum. There are these checkposts at every entry into this hill district. Stop the plastics there. There is 100 rupees fine per plastic bag brought in. Do it here and Munnar will blossom. Thirdly, I was discussing with my Tata Tea colleagues, next year you must have a parking policy where all the buses and cars are segregated somewhere, put in a maidan, hire it out, and bring in those electric buses, hire them from Bangalore. In the season, till the season is over, people should move around only in those buses. That's one thing. And of course, long-term things, the rejuvenation of water bodies. One of the good things this government has now done, it's going to become, you know, noticed very soon. If you pollute the water body in Kerala, you go to jail for 3 years. We need this kind of it's a little draconian, it's a little too much of an Uber state, but we need it so that people stop this nonsense. When I was a child, every stream in Kerala was alive with fishes and tadpoles. You don't see a stream anymore. So these are the things Munnar needs to do. I will stop here. This is some of the themes we put up on the station, Western Guards, the parakeets, and the blossom-headed parakeet or the blue, whatever it is. I don't know much about it. all inspired by James and his colleagues, you know. This is that hornbill is there on our station. And so we put a lot of world literature into our stations.